Halle Laura Channel, you're watching Millicent Fawcett. Who was Millicent Fawcett? Feminist and activist celebrated by Google. Millicent Fawcett has been honored with a Google Doodle, but who was the British feminist and activist born 171 years ago today? Today's Google Doodle is a homage to the indefatigable campaigner for women's rights, Dame Millicent Garrett Fawcett GBE. The image shows Ms. Fawcett leading a group of other suffragists protesting peacefully with banners held aloft. Ms. Fawcett was a suffragist. Members advocated peaceful methods of protests to achieve women's rights unlike suffragettes, and is viewed as one of the most instrumental voices in helping British women to gain the vote in 1918. A statue commemorating her life and legacy was unveiled on April 24, 1918. With Prime Minister Theresa May praising Ms. Fawcett's lasting impact. She also won a BBC Radio 4 poll this year for being one of the most influential women of the past 100 years. Who was Millicent Fawcett? Millicent Garrett Fawcett was born on June 11, 1847, in Aldeburgh, Suffolk, the eighth of 10 children. Her eldest sister, Elizabeth Garrett Anderson, became the UK's first female doctor and was the person to introduce her to influential suffragist Emily Davies. The young Millicent attended a private boarding school in Blackheath. Her passion for women's rights was ignited by hearing a speech in 1919 by Liberal Party politician John Stuart Mill, the first MP to argue for universal women's suffrage. Ms. Fawcett married the Cambridge academic Henry Fawcett in 1867. He had originally proposed to her sister Elizabeth but was rejected by her due to her aspirations to become a doctor. After making her first speech on women's suffrage in 1868, Ms. Fawcett, former the National Union of Women's Suffrage Societies, NUS, in 1897. The group advocated moderate, law-abiding methods of change rather than the more militant activities of suffragettes, such as Emmeline Pankhurst and the Women's Social and Political Union, WSPU. NUS a majority of support over WSPU and had surged to 50,000 members by 1905. Although activities were ceased after World War I broke out in 1914, the NUS continued to campaign for the vote by highlighting the contribution women had made to the war effort. Ms. Fawcett is today regarded as one of the instrumental individuals who helped 6 million British women gain the vote in 1918. At the time, the Representation of the People Act enabled women who were aged over 30 years and who owned £5 of property, or had a husband who did. The dame died in 1929, a year after the vote for all women over the age of 21 was granted in Parliament. The Fawcett Society, a British women's organisation, was named after her and a blue plaque was erected in her name in 1954. Ms. Fawcett's statue is the first one dedicated to a woman in Parliament Square. The statue includes a banner with a speech excerpt reading "Courage Calls to Courage Everywhere" that the dedicated campaigner gave after Emily Davidson's death during the 1913 Epsom Derby. Who was Millicent Fawcett and what were some of her famous quotes? Today's Google Doodle celebrates the birthday of suffragette Millicent Garrett, who campaigned for women's right to vote in the UK during the early 20th century. She was born on June 11, 1847 and went on to become a leading women's rights activist, leading the National Union of Women's Suffrage Societies for over 20 years. In 1918, many British women over the age of 30 were given the opportunity to vote for the first time, something that Millicent had worked hard to achieve. She remains a key figure for the suffragettes and a symbol of the fight for women's rights across the UK. What is the Fawcett Society? The Fawcett Society is a charity that campaigns for gender equality and women's rights in the UK, carrying on the work of Millicent Fawcett. The London Society for Women's Suffrage was renamed the Fawcett Society in 1953 to honour her legacy and show appreciation for her impact on gender equality. Some of the current campaigns include closing the gender pay gap, securing equal power and defending women's rights post-Brexit. The charity produces various reports and briefings, as well carrying out research and special projects focusing on equality in all areas of life. Where is the Millicent Fawcett statue? Millicent was given her own statue in Parliament Square in April 2018 to commemorate the 100th anniversary of voting rights being given to some women over 30 years old. The decision was made after a campaign that saw over 80,000 people sign an online petition. It features her displaying one of her most famous quotes that she said during a speech in 1913, "Courage calls to courage everywhere." It is the first statue of a woman to be erected in Parliament Square, and it was designed by artist Gillian Waring. Millicent Fawcett quotes. Millicent Fawcett made many famous quotes during her time campaigning and as president of the National Union of Women's Suffrage Societies. Here are some of her best-known quotes. "However benevolent men may be in their intentions, they cannot know what women want and what suits the necessities of women's lives as well as women know these things themselves. What draws men and women together is stronger than the brutality and tyranny which drive them apart. The evil state of the law, the evil state of the general tone of public opinion in regard to morals, is an outcome of the subjection of women, of the notion that women are possessions or chattels, with whom men are freely justified in dealing as they please. The real protection women needed was the power to protect themselves. The women brought under the influence of female emancipation will have a wider intellectual horizon, they will have more dignity and more happiness in their lives, in a word, we shall see the utmost expansion of which the female nature is capable. I feel that no one, man or woman, ought to be forced into marriage by fear of social or legal penalties. That is one main reason why I should like to see honorable and honored careers, other than marriage, open to women. Those who write and speak against the extension of liberty of action and conscience to men and women have always said that the change they deprecate will undermine or decompose the foundations of society. A few years pass by, the change is accomplished, and it turns out that society is not undermined or decomposed at all, but is all the healthier and more vigorous, through being possessed of a larger proportion of free citizens. We would greatly prefer an imperfect scheme that can pass to the most perfect scheme in the world that could not pass." On campaigning tactics, in 1917. "My husband took care that I should hear important debates in the House of Commons, and the Speaker and Sergeant-at-Arms were very kind in frequently offering me a seat in that portion of the ladies' galleries which they controlled. Thank you. Please share video and subscribe my channel for more video."